to the very first of many editing tutorials. Today we'll be learning several easy tips and tricks for faster video editing in Premiere Pro. And this can be applied to any kind of video, whether that's a reel, a YouTube video, client work, it doesn't matter, it's just gonna save you a lot of time. They're super simple and super easy to apply, so let's get right into it. My first tip for you is to create a custom folder in the effects panel of Premiere Pro where you can store all of the effects that you use often. Trust me, having those all in one place in an easy to access folder is gonna save you a lot of time. You won't have to type and look for something or scroll through one of the many folders that already exist. And to do this, it's really simple. Open up Premiere and make sure that you see the effects panel. If you don't see it, all you have to do is click Window and scroll down till you see Effects. And if there's not a check mark next to it already, just click it. And if there is a check mark, it will just open up the panel for you. Now in this panel, there's two ways you can create a custom bin. You can right click and then you'll see there New Custom Bin. Just click it. Or at the bottom right, you'll see a little folder symbol. And you can also click that and it will create a custom bin. Now to fill the bin, you can either just do it over time to see which effects you use the most, or just search up a few that you already know you use. For example, warp stabilizer. Just click it and drag it into your bin. And you can do this for as many effects as you want. Just search them, click them, and drag them into the bin. And then to check if your effects are there, just click the little arrow next to the bin, and you can see that your effects are right there, and you use them the same as you would normally, just drag and drop onto a clip. So now when you're editing, you'll be able to access the effects that you use often really easily just at the bottom of your effects panel without having to look for them every time. My second tip for you is actually how to access that effects folder without having to look through all of your panels to get to it. It saves me a lot of time and I know it will save you time too. So to do this, all you have to do is click Shift 7 and it will open up your effects panel no matter what. And to be able to set this effect up, you need to go to keyboard shortcuts. So click Premiere at the top left, scroll down to keyboard shortcuts, and then this screen will open up. In the search bar at the bottom left, just type in effect. Scroll down until you see it. To make this effect work with Shift 7, you just have to click Shift on the keyboard, and then take effects and drag it to 7. Click OK, and then you're done. My third tip for you is how to speed up and slow down a clip really quickly without having to open up a bunch of panels. Set up another keyboard shortcut. But first I'll show you what the trick is. We're gonna set it up so that when you click the letter R on your keyboard, this tool opens, and that's the rate change tool. What it does is it makes it so that you can change the speed of a clip by just clicking on it. You can either speed it up or slow it down. All you have to do is click and drag. Drag it smaller to speed it up or pull it to slow it down. To set this up, once again, you have to go to Premiere, open up keyboard shortcuts, type in rate stretch tool, and then you'll click on it here, and all you have to do is drag it to the letter that you want. So we drag it to R, then click OK, and you have that set up. To get back to your normal cursor, all you have to do is click A. And again, if that doesn't work for you, go to keyboard, type in selection tool, and drag that onto A. But that should be default on most of your computers. Tip number four is to help you refine specific clips. To do this, we're gonna use keys Q, W, and E. So what you do is you select your clip and put your cursor at the part that you wanna cut. I wanna get rid of the clip that comes before the cursor. So select your clip and click Q, and it will chop it off. To do that to the end of the clip, put your cursor where you wanna clip off the end and click E. And if you just want to cut your clip but not delete a segment, you can put your cursor where you want the cut to be and then click W. And to set these up, once again, go to keyboard shortcuts, and then for Q, to delete the beginning part of a clip, type in ripple trim, and then you'll see two options. Choose ripple trim previous edit to playhead and grab that and drag it onto Q. Take that and drag that onto E. To simply make a cut in your clip for W, type in add edit and just drag that onto W and then click OK. My fifth and final trick for you is how to paste settings between clips so you don't have to keep redoing the same thing to every single clip. So to do this, select your original clip. What I'm gonna do with this clip is I'm just gonna scale it up so it takes up the entire screen, and let's center the rock. Then we wanna do the same thing to the next clip, which you see here. Just go to your original clip, click motion, which is where your settings are. If that setting was in opacity, you would click opacity. Click motion and then do Command C to copy it. Then click on your second clip that you want to paste the settings on and do Command V. And then you'll see it's done the exact same thing. And you can do this with any sort of effect or setting that you like. So let's say we want to copy the Lumetri color, Command C. And then go to your second clip and do Command V, and your settings will paste. And of course, you might have to make adjustments between them, but it'll give you a general fast start. So those are my top 5 tips for faster and easier editing. And for 5 more bonus tips, check out my latest short. Thanks for watching, and keep your eyes peeled for the next editing video.